Hello, and welcome back. I have a new journal share. Yes, I'm crafting like nobody's business at the moment. Now, the reason why I was so quick, because I had the kit that I've used since last year. I had no time to create this, and now I desperately wanted to do it. I have used the beekeeper from Calco Collage, and even if we have just March, I'm done with winter. I need bright colors. I need spring and summer, please. So I made a very yellow, very, very yellow journal about bees. So it is just a soft cover journal. It's a little bit special because you probably know now. This cover here is an EcoDite envelope. And I've padded it with this padding that you can get for quilting. So it's a padded EcoDite envelope as a covered, soft cover journal, one signature. And even if it is a soft cover, it is here reinforced with cardstock. So this is snug and tight, bounded, and it's sturdy enough. So let me show you the back side. Squishy, I want to squishy. So it's a padded EcoDite envelope. This is all sari ribbon that I have colored with textile colors. It was an off-white, and that means you have here not just one tone of yellow. It is here a little lighter yellow, brighter yellow. So it's not completely equal colored, if I can say this. So, soft cover, this is, I must squish, squishy. The closure is completely removable. And it's fluffy, puffy thingy. So it opens up. Oh, here on the front, I made this little collage. This is an Edith Holden cardstock, vintage in the background, and this here, vintage music here, and this here is from Calco Collage, and so on around. Lots of sewing in this journal. I must finish it again. So okay, but now I open it. It's a DIN A5 size journal. So in the front, I have on the front and on the back side, I have pockets. So here again, you see it. Padded. Excuse me. I'm sorry. So, EcoDite envelope, and I have sealed it, the envelope, with Mod Podge to, of course, to protect the envelope, and the Mod Podge brings the colors much more out here. I think winter is over. Gorgeous pages from Calco Collage. Here, this here is not from Calco Collage. This was public domain, and I have printed the picture on a book page so that I have this script in the background. And I made this index card here with this little collage. This is yellow coffee stain paper. So I tried always to find book pages and pages with yellow. I need yellow. At the moment, I feel yellow. It's a large thingy. And I made this little tag here. This here is, I printed a couple of pages twice, or shrunk some down. And here I've torn a piece out of a page, and then this is the collage, and here are other papers. This is a book page from a Victorian flower album, and I've chosen to go white because it has yellow flowers, and I've sprayed it. Let me show you. here. I have this bottle. This is just water and the leftovers from ink pads. So whenever I have here an ink pad, and usually I refill them, but at one point, and I'll show you the reason, look, that is not good at all. So it's almost ruined, but I don't throw this away. I throw it into water, and this gives you this liquid and very brown. So when I cannot coffee stain, I spray it. So don't throw the old ink pads away. Usually I refill them. I have refiller, but at one point they are dead. So, and before I purchase a new one, I refill as much as often as I can, but at one point I need a new ink pad, and then I use the other ones and throw them into water to get this brown liquid. And I've sprayed it here on top. A triple pocket with little bits and pieces. You can always journal here on the back side if you wish. And a belly band and with an index card, mini collage here for me. Here, this is eco-dyed paper, and under this bumblebee there are fibers from the sari ribbon. If you don't like it, you can cut them off. It's also eco-dyed paper. Here is also some fibers underneath if you don't like them. Cut them off. Collage from me, take from me. Grid paper. This kit is really pretty. Doily. This is also from the Victorian Flower album. This is a bit from the Victorian. This page was from England is a Garden. I'm sorry. So this page is from the book England is a Garden, and this is the Victorian Flower album. Too many books. So this here is was an envelope from a junk mail, and I have, because I wanted to use this window, so I collaged here. This is a bee queen. It's from a Spanish vintage Spanish dictionary. This is eco-dyed, and we have this journal card in there, and you can see it through the window. This is parchment paper, coffee stained. Le collage. This is again coffee stained through a stencil. When I say through a stencil, I mean I coffee dye a piece of paper, I let it dry, I put a stencil on top, and then I spray with coffee again and let it sun dry. Because with the plastic stencil, you cannot oven dry it. Don't do it. This is an index card, yellow index card, and I have punched here this thingies. I think that's super interesting. Tucks under the spanner. More sari ribbon and more space for writing. Here I have punched out from the page with a scallop punch. This busy little bee. This here is from one of our envelopes here. They are similar to the Manila envelopes that you have in the US, but we have not this orangey color, but here it is more brown beige, something like that. And I had have received something in a large envelope, and the back side was totally super okay, and I have used it as a page. And the front, there was stamping and the addresses, and I have used bits and pieces from the front to collage. I'll show you this in a second. This is a book page from White Flowers of the World. Here, this is what I mean. This piece was also from the envelope, from the large envelope, but from the front where there was stamping and addresses, and I don't wanted to put them in here. So, but I could collage here and give you here some journal space. This is a tag that I have cut out from one of the pages and flips out. And here we come to the Ecodite page that I have included as my center. And this is so bright and yellow that had to be here in this journal, so that an original is not printed. More journal cards, I've backed them always with coffee stained cardstock or coffee stained paper. Loose fibers for free. And our paper in Germany is acid free. That's maybe good to know. Here again, another piece of this large envelope. And I turned it all into a collage. Here's some yellow lined paper that I have also sprayed here with this brown something. Skillet punch. Again, tag that flips out. And this time I thought this beehive here, and this flips out to this way. Here, can you see it? It's also from a stencil that I have purchased from Linda Israel. And the same process, I had a page coffee stand, then I put the stencil from Linda Israel on top, and then I sprayed it again and let it sun dry. I made these pages last summer. I made a lot. So this folds out, this beehive folds out in this direction. When you turn it around, we have a beehive here, and this folds out in this direction. Whew. Little fussy cut element with the bee. It's a large journal card and the tag I made. It says beekeeping. Yeah, I made this. I have printed a page, and I cut it into strips, backed it to give it a little bit more strength, and then I have sewn it on this page as a tuck. Here's the other part. Here's some space for journaling. This is Ecodite paper here. It's also Ecodite or paper originals. So I have some printables in my shop, but I use here the originals. Triple pocket again with some bits and pieces here. And another belly band with an index card. Big fat tag that's from Calco Collage, and this is from me. And another tag pocket. This is also from a public domain, and I printed it on a book page. And this is the last page here, and here again, journal card and a tag. It's really squishy. I love it. I really love it. And I will definitely make another one also with this envelope cover. This is so gorgeous. So I hope you like it. If you are interested in this kit, I will link Calco Collage in the description box, as well as my shop for the journal. It will be listed as soon as you rewatch the video. If it's not there, it's gone. I'm sorry. So, I hope you like it, guys. I hope to see you soon. Thanks for watching. Have a fabulous day. Bye-bye.